Alright everyone, weekend na naman no? So, balik na naman po tayo sa ating mga crypto weekend reviews. As we discussed last week, I was gonna start this new mini-series where our focus was primarily on AXS and SLP. The reason being, mas marami kasi nag-request ng mga ganito or maraming tanong dun sa dalawang yon. So I decided it would be better kung may separate siya na video para number one, mas mabigyan ko rin siya ng mas maraming oras. And number two, dun sa normal crypto weekend recap natin, mas matutukan din natin ng ibang mga coins. Okay? So, start na tayo no, sa AXS. Maraming nangyari. So, last week when we were looking at this, we were around here. Okay? In this candle here. So, we were saying na nagpo-form na to, okay, before, ng high, low, lower high, lower low. And what we didn't want to see was for price to break down below this white zone here. Diba? Yun yung sabi natin last week. And for bullish scenario, we wanted a quick consolidation sa area na to. Diba? Where price was. And then for it to break up, then break higher. So, medyo ganun nga, no? Medyo sumunod sa plano. Price tried to pull back here to come back into this white zone. Okay? Bumitin ng konti, tapos nag-reject. And then we close back within that range. And then what happened from there was price moved higher, tested the high end of the range, and then eventually broke through it. And then kahapon, malakas na breakout yung naganap. Okay? Malakas sa breakout, binasag natin tong resistance na to dito, binasag din natin tong resistance na to dito. And then today, okay, nandito na tayo sa candle na to, tapos tinitignan natin anong mangyayari. Okay, huwag natin pangunahan. Let's just be happy na nag-play out yung bullish scenario natin. And let's see what happens next. Some of the things that could happen is possible na mag-pull back tayo. Bumalik tayo do sa area of previous resistance. So either here or even up to here, no? I don't think we pull back up to here, but we might. Okay? So we might pull back up to here. Then from there, baka gumanon yung price ng konti. Then let's see kung mag-break out, then tumuloy. Either challenge the highs again or break higher. Of course, what everyone would prefer, lahat ng bulls would just prefer na tumuloy lang siya pataas. And syempre, masaya rin naman ako para sa inyo kung may hawak kayo na AXS. Congratulations. Be sure to trail your stops lang in accordance to whatever system that you use. However, I would just like to remind you na normally, yung mga galaw na puro green lang, tuloy-tuloy lang na malalaki, while yes, makakalabas kayo ng malakas, yung kumbaga malaki yung kita, pero kung hindi kayo nakalabas, masyado kayong matagal nag-hold, masyado naging greedy, madalas mabilis din makain yung mga ganong type of moves if magkaroon tayo ng pullbacks. Meaning, kunyari ito, sunod-sunod na green na ganyan, nagkaroon tayo ng severe pullback, usually magpapanik agad yung mga tao and then magkaroon ng severe sell-down, babalik na naman tayo dito sa area of previous consolidation na to, which I assume is not something that everyone likes unless you're shorting AXS. Alright, so konting ingat lang. If you're planning to short AXS naman, okay, since pwede tayo mag-short ng mga cryptocurrencies, okay, I wouldn't right now. Medyo malakas yung buwelo niya. I would wait for structure to develop dito sa taas, magpakita ng weakness, tsaka ako mag-short. And again, if I short this, my target would be around 95, 94.67 area. Alright? Next, let's take a look at SLP. Okay, unfortunately, despite AXS na strength, hindi sumunod yung SLP, no? When we last looked at SLP, nagkaroon tayo na rejection dito. Sabi natin, we tried to break above tong level na to at 0.08. Nag-reject. Price push lower. Okay, hindi naman niya binasag yung low. Nag-range tayo at nagko-continue tayo na mag-range within this area. Okay. Yes, it's tempting to say that this candle is very bullish and kailangan pumasok na, kailangan all in na, 'di ba? And so on. Okay, it's very bullish na and yung parang to the moon na mentality. Yan na hinihintay ko. But we still need to wait for confirmation. Last week na sinabi ko, wala pa rin nagbago in the sense na we want to break above this pink zone here. Okay? Break above this pink zone there. Para lang masabi natin na na-clear natin tong mga hurdles na to. Then we have a clean canvas, itong area na to work with where price can start pushing higher and or working within a higher and larger range. Okay, so we wanted to clear tong point 10, more or less point 10, point 11, para maging workable range is point 10, point 11 hanggang point 16, point 17. Okay, what we don't want to see is for it to break down, clear tong point 055, kasi new lows na, what might happen then is tuluyan ng gumulong, tuluyan ng malunod. Alright, so yun yung ayaw natin makita. So kung mag-range siya dito, again, sabi nga natin last week, kung ang presyo hindi desidido, dapat tayo rin hindi pa desidido. Alright, kung nag-range siya dyan, hintay lang, kung nag-breakdown, then kung gusto nyo mag-short, baka pwede. Pero sa mga bulls, medyo tagilid, no? Kung nag-break for bulls, what you want to see is a break above this pink slash red zone here para we have a new workable area that we can discuss. Alright, for now, sa bigger picture, SLP still looks very bearish. Okay, and as we discussed before, and napatunayan na tama, sa bigger picture, AXS still looked bullish. And now is still looking even more bullish, no? Alright? So guys, I hope na enjoy nyo tong mini-series na to. I'm not sure if it's something that we should continue. Okay, hindi ko alam how popular it is or how much you guys like it. So if you like it, if you want this to continue, be sure to give this video a thumbs up. Click that like button, no? And consider subscribing to my channel. And maybe, you know, drop a few comments kung na-appreciate nyo yung ganito na nag-focus tayo on these two cryptocurrencies. Para lang alam ko that it's something that we should continue week after week after week. Alright, guys? So as always, maraming salamat po sa patunood. Good luck and happy trading!